In part 4 of our lesson on trig equations with multiple angles, you will learn how to solve an equation whose argument is in the form quantity bx plus c. In this example, we have to find all solutions on the interval 0 to 2 pi for the equation 2 radical 3 times the sine of the quantity 4x plus pi over 6 is equal to radical 6. First step we know is to isolate the trig function, so we will want to divide both sides by 2 radical 3, and we get sine of 4x plus pi over 6 is equal to radical 6 divided by 2 radical 3. The left-hand side will stay the same, sine of 4x plus pi over 6 equals. Now on the right-hand side, we have a radical 6 in the numerator and a radical 3 in the denominator. Since they're both under the radical, we can divide them, and this would become radical 2, and we still have 2 in the denominator. We know that when the sine function is positive, that means that our angles have to be in quadrants 1 and 2. Looking at our special angle chart in the sine row for radical 2 over 2, we see that our reference angle is going to be pi over 4. So if we put that reference angle in quadrant 1, we know we get pi over 4. If we put theta r in quadrant 2, we know we will have to do pi minus pi over 4, and we will get 3 pi over 4. We're ready now to make our equations. So we know we have to take the argument of our function, which is 4x plus pi over 6, and set it equal to the angles we got plus 2n pi. So the first angle is pi over 4, and we add 2n pi, or we will get a second equation where we take the argument of our function, 4x plus pi over 6, and we set it equal to the second angle we got, 3 pi over 4 plus 2n pi. Now we need to solve each of these equations for x. Starting with this first equation, to get x by itself, the first thing we are going to need to do is to subtract pi over 6 from both sides. Now on the left-hand side, that's easy enough to do. We end up with 4x. On the right-hand side, we will need a common denominator between 6 and 4. We know that's going to be 12, so minus pi over 6 will be minus 2 pi over 12. We know that pi over 4 is 3 pi over 12. So 3 pi over 12 minus 2 pi over 12 means we're going to end up with pi over 12. And then we still have the plus 2n pi. Getting a common denominator on that right-hand side, we see it's going to be 12. So we will multiply the 2n pi by 12 over 12. Our equation becomes 4x is equal to, the numerator will be pi plus 24n pi, and the denominator is 12. To get x by itself, we will need to divide by 4, which of course is the same as multiplying by 1/4. We see that our equation becomes x is equal to pi plus 24n pi divided by 48. So here's the first formula for all solutions. Now we'll turn our attention to the second equation over here. We will need to subtract pi over 6 from both sides. The left-hand side is easy enough to simplify. It becomes 4x equals, on the right-hand side, we will need to get a common denominator. We can see it's going to be 12 again. So the minus pi over 6 becomes minus 2 pi over 12. And the 3 pi over 4 is going to become 9 pi over 12. So 9 pi over 12 minus 2 pi over 12 will be 7 pi over 12. And we still have the plus 2n pi. To get a common denominator, on the right-hand side, we will multiply the 2n pi by 12 over 12. So our equation becomes 4x is equal to, the numerator is 7 pi plus 24n pi, and the denominator is 12. We will need to divide by 4, which we know means it's easiest to multiply by 1/4. And we get that x is equal to 7 pi plus 24n pi divided by 48. Now these two formulas find all the infinitely many solutions there are to this equation. Our job now is to plug in for n to find out which of those solutions lands between 0 and 2 pi. We will be plugging in for n and using the two formulas that we have. We know that n has to be an integer, so if we start with 0, plug it into this first formula, that wipes out the 24n pi, and we are left with pi over 48. Now we know we have to decide if that is in our interval of 0 to 2 pi. We want to make that an interval from 0 to a fraction whose denominator matches our formulas, which is 48. So we know that 2 pi is equal to 96 pi over 48, because 96 divided by 48 is equal to 2. So clearly, pi over 48 is in that interval. So we keep going. Next, we plug 0 into the second formula, which wipes out the 24n pi, and we get 7 pi over 48. If we plug in 1 to the first formula, we'll get 24 pi plus pi is 25 pi over a denominator of 48, still within the interval. Plugging into the second equation, we get 24 pi plus 7 pi is equal to 31 pi over 48. Next, we plug in n is equal to 2. 2 times 24. So here we would get 48 pi plus 1 is 49 pi over 48. So we keep going. Plugging the 2 into the second formula, we get 48 plus 7 is equal to 55 pi over 48. We keep going because we're still within the interval. We plug in 3. 24 times 3 is 72. So we have 72 pi plus pi is 73 pi over 48. Still within the interval. Plugging n equals 3 into the second formula, we get 72 pi plus 7 pi is equal to 79 pi over 48. Still within the interval. Now, if we were to plug in n equals 4, 24 times 4 is 96. So we're already at the 96, and then we would be adding another one. So clearly, that would take us outside our interval. So that means these are the 8 solutions to our equation.